Good morning, or whenever you're watching this. I'm very excited about this trip because we're doing something we haven't done in a very, very long time, and that is go to Disneyland in California. We're annual pass holders at Disney World, so it makes more sense to go there if we're going to do multiple trips, but Josh and I haven't been in 7 years, and that was an itch that we decided we wanted to scratch, and so we're doing a quick in-and-out weekend trip. We fly in on a Saturday morning, we fly out Sunday night. Josh and I used to go to Disneyland all the time. The first time we went was in 2007, and then the next time was in 2008, and then pretty much every year afterwards. It used to be once a year, then it turned into like two times a year, then eventually it was three times a year. We'd go to Disneyland. But then for our honeymoon, we went to Disney World and kind of fell in love with that. Went to Disneyland one or two more times, and then since then, it's all been Disney World. But we decided that it was time to go back out to California, visit what we considered to be our home park for the longest time, and we wanted to bring you along to our journey to Disneyland and Disney's California Adventure. I wasn't doing videos at the time, so I don't have any videos of us there except for like little snippets here and there on old phones that have crappy cameras, so definitely not worth putting on a channel. But here's my first opportunity to actually make a video of Disneyland, which is, you know, our home park. So come and join us. Here we are at Disneyland Resort. Yay! Finally made it. Plane ride wasn't too bad. Left on time, landed early. And now we checked into our hotel early, which is great. And now it's time to get in the park, make some lightning lane choices, and ride some rides, eat some food. This area here is called the Esplanade, and unlike Disney World, where those are four parks and they're very far apart from each other, this Disneyland Resort consists of Disneyland, which is over here, and California Adventure, which is right over there. So the parks are just across this Esplanade. And the Esplanade contains a whole bunch of these bricks with people's names on them. And Josh and I have a brick here, and we haven't visited it for 7 years, so we're gonna go find it later. We wanna get in the parks now and start riding some rides, but I'll video it later once we go and find it. But it's Halloween time here at Disneyland, so they have the pumpkins up that look like the characters. Oh my gosh, so many memories. And then the monorail comes right through here. You can see the monorail track. Oh wow, this is so cool. I didn't realize how much I missed this place. And here you go, I wasn't lying. This is mine and Josh's little piece of Disneyland that we got back in, like it says there, 2011, so it's been 11 years now. And it was, I think, about $120 when we did it, which for back then was an expense for us. And so we were kind of hemming and hawing about it, but I really love the fact that it is here, and it's still here 11 years later. Our little piece of Disneyland. Oh my. As I mentioned before, although the memories are flooding back, we've spent so much time at Disney World, I forget how quaint Disneyland is. Everything's just, you know, a little bit smaller. In Disney World, the town square here is just a little bit bigger, and there's more in it. But that's okay. I think this is beautiful. And of course, an emporium. Both of the parks have an emporium. This is not necessarily going to be a comparison vlog because, honestly, I love both. And there are some rides I like there better and some rides that I like here better. But I think that's probably true of anybody who comes to the places. There's always going to be some kind of comparison, but I'm not going to say one's better than the other because I love both. And it really fills me with joy walking back into this park again after so long. Ah, and there it is. The castle down at the end of Main Street. Oh, there's live band playing over here. The cinema. That's really cool, the man. Get a view of them for a moment. Disney clothiers. I bought a lot of stuff there in the past. Carnation Cafe. Josh has eaten there a lot in the past. Oh, it's so wonderful. I'm sorry, I'm just geeking out. I hope you're geeking out with me. And just hadn't realized how much I missed this. We didn't actually plan this for very long. We were talking about it. Something had come up in like my video feed, and we were lamenting about how long it's been since we've been to Disneyland. And so I was like, well, you know, let's see how much it'll cost if we go. Let's look, you know, and of course, if you're trying to book it, like, because we only thought about this last Sunday, and today is a Saturday. And usually when you're this close, the plane tickets are really expensive, the hotels are expensive, but no, they really weren't. They were normally priced. And so, okay, here we go. So I just booked it all last Sunday for a trip this Saturday and Sunday, so today and tomorrow. And we're gonna try to make the most out of it as we can. We may not be able to do everything, but this will scratch the itch of going to Disneyland that we've been wanting to do. Oh, the Jolly Holiday Bakery. And there's a corn dog cart over there that we're definitely going to get a corn dog from at some point today, probably later as a snack, because the corn dogs in Disney World, not so great. Here, they're hand dipped and hand fried, and they're amazing. And look, it's the Matterhorn. Matterhorn is not open right now. It's under refurbishment. And we are going to make our way over to Frontierland because we have the Big Thunder Mountain Railroad Lightning Lane that I just got as soon as we got into the park. So we need to go to Frontierland, which is right there. And then, of course, Adventureland's right over there. And Fantasyland is through the castle over there. And Tomorrowland is over there. And that brightly colored pavilion over there, they do shows, like live shows of retellings of some of the fairy tale stories.
Oh, wow.
Heading into Frontierland. Over here on the left, there are people trading pins. Hey, Josh has that shirt that guy has over there. Oh, the Pioneer Mercantile. We used to shop in there all the time. Definitely want to get some pins here, and there's actually a pin store here, which is why I think the pin traders are around it. One of our favorite restaurants is over here to the right, Rancho de Zocalo, which for the longest time we said Zocalo, but apparently it's Zocalo. And we'll probably eat there for dinner. We have lunch reservations. We'll probably eat there for dinner, but we do have to head this way to get to the Big Thunder Mountain Railroad. And then straight ahead is the Mark Twain riverboat. And it says there's no more reservations left for the park, although the park doesn't seem that busy right now, so maybe more people will be coming later. Yeah, I'm not complaining about that. The lines are not that bad. Maybe that'll get different or be more later, but during Zocalo, they also do a kind of Day of the Dead in this area. But yeah, let's head over here and get in the Lightning Lane entrance to Big Thunder. Which is 30 minutes right now, but we're lightning landing, so we're not going to take that long. But 30 minutes is not that bad for this ride, as far as I remember.
I was using the appropriate terminology.
Our chariot arrives. Our chariot is a train. Here we go. First ride of the trip, and it's appropriate that it's Big Thunder Mountain. And now it's dark. Ooh, the water's working. It's a little drippy. Yay! Wolves! Or coyotes, actually. Oh! This is my favorite part coming up. It's a double spin. This one is pretty smooth, actually. This is different than it is in Disney World. There's dynamite blowing up. Yay! This is so exciting. And then you pass the little town here at the end. We did it. Oh, this is so much fun. See, I didn't lie. We did go by the corndog cart to get our hand-dipped corndog, which looks amazing. We got the specialty sauce, which apparently it's kind of spicy. I'm not sure what it tastes like. And then it comes with chips, or you could get a little orange with it, an orange cutie. And then we got a soda too. Oh, Calvin got the cutie and the corndog. And yeah, so we're gonna dig into this. Tide us over until we have our lunch in, I don't know, an hour and a half or so.
Yep.
Our next lightning lane is for Space Mountain. So we're hitting a couple of the mountains here in Tomorrowland. There's the Astral Orbiter going. That is not Space Mountain, even though I was mentioning it. It is not. That is the Astral Orbiter. And Star Tours is right here at the entrance as well. And Buzz Lightyear's Astro Blasters is over there on the left. And this, what looks like a track here, used to be a people mover back in the day, and then it was a ride called Rocket Rods, and then it hasn't really been anything for a long time, although I've heard rumors that they might be bringing a people mover back to Disneyland, so, you know, it's just rumors, so who knows if that will end up being true, but that would be cool. I do like people mover rides. If you've seen any of my other videos from Disney World, you know how much I love the people mover. I love the giant mural up there, showing just a space scene and Space Mountain looking space stations. Oh, they look more like flying saucers, don't they? And there's a lot of moons right next to each other. I think they'd create a lot of gravitational problems. We have just a few minutes before our lightning lane is up, so we're gonna go into Star Traders, which is in Tomorrowland, obviously, and has a lot of Star Wars merchandise as well as other stuff. Let's see what they have for Halloween. So there's a Star Wars Halloween there with all the droids. I do really like that. And there's one with the child holding a candy bucket saying trick or treat. Actually, he's below too, in the candy bucket. Okay, that's pretty cool. Here's another one with the child. Some droid factory droids. Oh, that one's cool. The Force surrounds you. I should get some prices on these. This shirt here was $20. This shirt here was $37. That's quite a bit for a t-shirt. And there is a Christmas ornament. I suppose you could hang it anywhere. It's $23, looks like the child. This looks like a ditch towel. Yeah, it's kitchen towels. And they are 22, and so there's a Grogu, and then another one with that same design on it that was on the t-shirt. They're pretty cool. And then a candy bucket, which, yeah, it's ceramic, for $40. Oop. More shirts over here. This one is $30. And the droids were $50. Really? Yeah, that's $50. Seems like a lot. And there's a mat down there. We actually just bought a mat from Disney World. It's not this one, but we did buy a mat, and we had it shipped to us because we didn't want to take it back in our luggage. Oh, Pizza Planet has become Alien Pizza Planet. I don't think I knew that. Was it still? It was still Pizza Planet last time we were here, right, Josh?
They changed
it. I think they just added the alien part, which is cool. But I don't think it was that when we were here last time. I don't remember exactly, though, but that seems new to me. So our lightning lane is just about up, so we're gonna head over here to Space Mountain. If we are talking about comparisons, I like the Space Mountain here better than I do the one in Disney World, because this one is a two-seater as opposed to the Disney World one, which is a one-seater. And I don't like one-seaters as much. I feel like they're too, like, rickety. Whereas this one is a lot more comfortable. Plus, this one has the music in the car with you, as opposed to just ambient music. Anyway, I don't know if I'm going to be able to film this, because usually you can't film these kinds of rides, but I did film the other roller coaster, so maybe I can. I guess we'll find out.
The lights are not over.
That galaxy is spinning very quickly. Oh. Oh, going up one more time. I forgot about that. 3, 2, 1, launch. I always like this song. These statues are actually really cool. One thing about it is they were made, I think, in Italy. We saw something about this. They're made in Italy, and they didn't realize that Snow White wasn't supposed to be the size of the dwarves. So she's the same size as they are, so they did this whole kind of trick where she's up above them, and there's a little bit of forced perspective so that she seems like she's bigger than they are. But the creators of this, when they got the pictures of the characters to sculpt, they didn't realize that she was supposed to be a different size, and so they made everybody the same size. Cool. And this over here is the Snow White Fountain, and this right here is where I proposed to Josh many, many years ago, but it was right here, right at this fountain. Here we are in Fantasyland. Right when you walk in through the castle, there is the King Arthur's Carousel here. And to your right is Peter Pan's flight. And to your left, which I'm turning right, but it's on the left when you walk in, is Snow White's Scary Adventures. And then Pinocchio's Daring Journey is right there. And Casey Jr.'s and the Storybook Land Canal Boats are behind this. We'll go over there in a minute. And the Dumbo's over that way. You can just barely see it over there, but Dumbo's that way. Next ride is Casey Jr. Train. Actually, what's the full term for this? I forget. It's a Casey Jr. Train ride. Last time we did one of these rides was in Paris Disneyland. They had one that was actually a steel coaster, not like the old style coaster like this one is. I mean, this one's great too, don't get me wrong, but that one, this one is just like normal train tracks kind of thing. But the one over there was steel coaster. It was a lot of fun, but it was a little more intense than this one. Not like
a little kid's
coaster. Terribly intense. It was still a kid's coaster, but not as slow as this one. It was a little bit faster. I love how this goes through the same kind of storybook land and sings the Casey Jr. song. He's stacked. Over there. We haven't gone by them yet, and the Matterhorn behind it there. Small world's that way. I don't know if we'll be able to get a good view from this. But there's the canal boats. We'll probably do that later. They also had those in Disneyland Paris, and they were fairly similar, except they didn't have the live, the people sitting there, the cast members giving you the info about it. It was all pre-recorded. Which I'm kind of surprised they haven't done here yet. I like this part. I think I can. I think I can. I think I can. I... Turns out he can. There's the backside of the castle and the carousel. Pinocchio's thing, now it's the Red Rose Tavern. That's the patchwork quilt. Here's part of it here. When you see it from a distance, it all kind of flows together. Maybe my memory is different, but I remember it being sort of like more flowery, but I think they're trying to get more as Disneyland goes on and California has more droughts, switching over to where they don't have to use as much water, right? I know that they've replacing some of the grass with AstroTurf, like at the Mickey out front. And I don't know if they've done it yet, but I've read an article that they're going to be if they haven't already. But it's a nice AstroTurf, like you almost can't tell the different kind of thing, so that they don't have to water it as much and be a little bit more water conscious. I love all the little miniatures. There's a castle up there. In a village. Not sure which village it is. Ooh, a tunnel. Oh, it looks like we're coming to the end. Yep, that's the whole ride right there. These trellises are pretty cool. You go underneath them in the storybook land canal boats. Next ride will be the King Arthur's Carousel. We weren't necessarily going to ride this, but it's pretty much a walk-on. Once this ends, we're going to pop right on and get some video of that. We were going to do the storybook land canal boats, but we don't have time before we have to go to our lunch, so we're going to do this and then head over that way to Café Orleans, which is mine and Josh's favorite place to eat in the park. And we were very lucky to get a reservation last minute. One of these horses was Walt Disney's wife, Lillian's favorite horse. And you can tell because it has a gold tooth. I don't see it right here. I've ridden on it before, but I don't remember which one it is. It's been a while. Here we go. Slowly moving on the carousel. So there's Josh ahead of me there. And here's Calvin over here. And this is Fantasyland. Pinocchio's Daring Journey. The back of the castle. Peter Pan's Flight. Mr. Froggy Face's Crash Course. Actually, Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. There's Dumbo there. I don't know if you can see that very well through the... That's nice that they put those up. And so, were they there before? I keep questioning myself whether something was there or not. It just protects you from the sun while you're standing there in the line, which is cool. There's Monstro over there from the Storybook Land canal boats. Ah, fun. There's a lot of people on the... We didn't actually find the horse with the golden tooth, but we only walked about a quarter of it before we decided to just grab some horses before they got taken. But I don't think this is full, because there's one next to me, so... Probably could have kept looking, but meh. I know carousels are very simple rides, but I enjoy them. Sometimes it's nice just to have a simple ride. Sword in the Stone over there. We have not been here since they added Star Wars Land, or Batuu, and we weren't exactly sure where the entrances were. We knew there was one over in Critter Country, and we thought there was one back here, and sure enough, there is. So we're coming into Star Wars Land, Galaxy's Edge. Oh, this tunnel is really cool. Just a little bit after the tunnel, you come to Batuu. You pass the sound wall, and wow, this seems so open. I love it. Oh, there's the blue and green milk over here, and there's the ship on the stage. Yeah, now I know where I am. Smuggler's Run is over that way if it's built the same way.
It's very similar, but not exactly.
And there's that shop. Josh and I are not a huge fan of the blue and green milk, so we don't usually get it. Is there a... the cantina over here? Yep, sure enough, the cantina's over here. Yeah, so I guess it's built identically to the other one. I mean, probably minor differences, but for the most part, I think it's built the same way. There's the Millennium Falcon, and the standby wait time for this is only 15 minutes. We don't have 15 minutes right now because we have to get to our lunch, but we'll probably come back here so we can do this all together, but... yeah. It feels very comfortable because we know it so well in Disney World to come here, and it's built pretty much the same way, so we know how to get around without feeling confused. Docking Bay 7. So food and drink there. And if I'm right, there should be a Ronto's Roasters around here. There's a shop over there. It has the Star Wars stuff. I mean, there's everything here has Star Wars stuff, but you can get some accessories for your lightsaber, other kyber crystals for different colors if you want to. I used to pick them up for my friend Wes. You've seen them. Oh, yep, there's the Ronto wraps over there. Anyway, I used to pick up the kyber crystals with my friend Wes, but he has all the colors now, so we don't have to pick anything up for him anymore. But I am going to ask if he wants us to pick up anything for him while we're here. We're over here. Ooh, that's a nice shirt. Sorry, I got distracted. We're over here near Rise of the Resistance. And in Disney World, this X-Wing is over here. But obviously, there, like I said, there's minor differences. You know, based on how they have to build it. But hey, that's cool. Rise of the Resistance is 65 minutes right now, I think that says. The 5 and the 6 kind of look the same. I think it's 65. Or you can pay $20 a person to get on it. We're not going to do that. I would potentially wait an hour for that ride, but I wouldn't pay $20 for it because we've ridden it in Disney World plenty of times. But we'll see what the line is later and see if we want to grab that. But yeah, we decided to use Batuu as a walkway to get over to New Orleans Square so we can get to Café Orleans, which is up in about 10 more minutes, so we need to move it. 10 minutes is plenty of time to get there from where we are. And there's Kevin and Josh. But yeah, I like the plants. It's like when you go to Animal Kingdom and you're in the Avatar area, they have very strange looking plants. Even though they're mostly earthy plants, they look for ones that look kind of weird and alien-ish and not usual. So, yeah. And then this is the way into Critter Country from here. You walk by the Hungry Bear restaurant, and this is the other entrance and or exit from Star Wars Land. That's so cool. And what we're a big fan of here is now it connects, right? Critter Country for the longest time was a dead end. So we are a big fan of the fact that it now connects to another place, so you don't have a dead end that you have to walk out from. You can connect to the other part of the park by walking through Batuu. And that's very smart, and I'm glad they did that. Walking by Critter Country, Splash Mountain there. And this time of year, the Haunted Mansion is done up for Nightmare Before Christmas, and they keep it all the way through Halloween and Christmas time because it covers both of those holidays. So for about a third of the year, or maybe a quarter of the year, it's done differently than the usual. But yeah, we have a lightning lane for that after our lunch, so we can get into it quickly afterwards, because we haven't seen it like this, obviously, in a long time. They don't do this to it in Disney World. They keep it traditional all the year round. But here, they change it to the Nightmare Before Christmas version, which is very exciting.
As long as you were a local company.
Yeah, because one of the things we used to dislike when we would come here all the time is that sometimes we'd like to see it the way it was, not how it's done up like this. But since we're only going to be here for one day, probably only going to ride it one time, it's perfectly fine. There's the Rivers of America, where later tonight the show Fantasmic will be. We're hoping to get some good standing room only for that. See how that goes. And the French Market is over here. Mine and Josh's favorite land is New Orleans Square, because we just love the aesthetic, and we used to come here long before we ever went to New Orleans. Hey, check out those videos if you want to see our trip to New Orleans. But now this means something to me, because I've actually been there and I recognize the architecture. Mostly, what was interesting is when we were in New Orleans, I was looking at the architecture there and comparing it to this, where this is based on that, not the reverse, right? It's so weird. Anyway, here's Café Orleans. Favorite place to eat in Disneyland, and we're gonna go check in. Here's the menu. So you've got your small bites, which are your appetizers, and then the entrees down here. We're gonna get the Monte Cristo sandwich, which is the reason why we come here, and let's find out what their sweets are. They used to serve beignets here, but I don't see them anymore. Which is interesting. I mean, you can still get them over at the Mint Julep Bar, which is close to the French Market over there, if we want to get some. But they used to serve them here, so I'm going to ask about it to see what they have going on, just in case, because I'd rather get them here. One of the things I like about eating at Café Orleans is they have an indoor area, which I think we've only ever eaten at once, because we prefer to eat at the balcony. Not balcony, it's a patio. So you can people watch as people go by, and the Mark Twain goes by, and the Sunburner goes by. And actually, it's the pirate ship over there. Oh, I can't remember the name of it. What's the name of the Sunburner? The Columbia. I couldn't remember it. Anyway, it's a pretty good view of New Orleans Square. Josh and I ordered the Monte Cristo sandwich, which is a ham and cheese sandwich that has been breaded and deep fried and has powdered sugar on it. And then you spread raspberry preserves on it. I know on paper that sounds terrible, but it is actually incredibly delicious. And it comes with palm frites, which are just french fries with a remoulade sauce. And then Calvin got the roasted chicken, which comes with mashed potatoes and like a vegetable medley?
Yes, potatoes and squash, I think.
Okay, did you have a bite already? How was it?
I have not, but it looks amazing.
Okay, yeah, it does really look amazing. I wasn't sure if it was like a chicken breast or if it was actually like a roast chicken on the bone, and it is roast chicken on the bone.
Oh, wow.
It looks very moist.
It's really tasty.
Is it?
Got a lot of like herb flavor in there.
Yeah, there's a good looking sauce on it, some kind of gravy that looks delicious. Okay, cool. Oh, Josh had a bite of the Monte Cristo. What'd you think? I always ask Josh before, or when he takes a bite. He can talk with his mouth full, though.
It's good. I wish it were kind of crispier. It doesn't feel quite as
crispy. Oh, you want it to be crispier. Oh, I see what you're saying. Well, let me try it myself, see what
it's
I think.
Good.
Lunch was delicious, as usual. The Monte Cristo sandwich could have been a little crispier, but it still was food-wise, or taste-wise, delicious. Calvin also really enjoyed his chicken, he said. So altogether, everything we had was just about $58 with tax, which is, you know, not too bad. It's a little kind of expensive there for what you get, but Josh and I split things, so it's not too bad. I love the idea of the Monte Cristo, because sort of like, I imagine people being in a room being like, hey, do you know how everybody likes ham and cheese sandwiches? And you know how everybody likes funnel cakes? Well, have I got an idea for you? And that's where I think the funnel cake was born. But, I'm sorry, the Monte Cristo sandwich was born. Anyway, we recommend that place. It is our favorite place to eat here. They have made a lot of changes since we've been here last, but they still had the Monte Cristo, and that's what we wanted, so that's what we got. So now we're in the lightning lane for the Haunted Mansion holiday, and it's actually pretty backed up, the lightning lane is. So I don't know how long it's going to take us to get in, but I think it's still going to be faster than the standby line. I love this pet cemetery out front where you've got the cat and then a bunch of birds that it killed. And Rosie, She was a poor little pig, but she bought the farm. And a bunny, and Buddy, our friend till the end. Aw, our neighbors downstairs have a dog named Buddy. And a squirrel. Oh man, I'd forgotten about these. Stripey, you may be departed, but your essence will always linger on. Ha ha ha, clever. Yeah, well, this big tree is in the way, with the Spanish moss on it, which we found out on a tour of New Orleans that it is neither Spanish nor moss. And the lightning lane was long to get in, and then but I think it's pretty quick once we get here.
The story that you were about to be told began the holiday worlds of old. I know you're curious to see what's inside. It's what happens when two holidays collide. Was the nightmare before Christmas and all through the house. Not a creature was peaceful, not even a mouse. The stockings, all hung by the chimney with care, when opened that morning, would cause such a scare. The children nestled all snug in their beds, would have nightmares of monsters and skeleton heads. This year he's decided to play Santa Claus. But when Halloween creates Christmas, you might see a few flaws.
Zero moves from picture to picture. There he is on the right.
She'll take you away. Sit back. Rest in peace. In your black Christmas sleigh. Your sleigh will accommodate one or two more. People could bear for a
hey, that's cool. The ho ho ho, but it's in a spider web. I don't know if you can see that very well. Same thing with Noel. And are the faces looking at us on the video? I can't tell how that works with the video. The faces follow you here. I guess they kind of do. That's pretty cool. And then here's the Doom buggies, the Omnimover system.
More rapid than vultures, the mansion was changed. All was soon covered, adorned, and deranged. And what to your wondering eyes disappears is Jack's little friend.
And Zero down the endless hallway.
A man like that makes a wonderful wreath. As long as he don't.
I love how this plant is grabbing the chandelier there.
Jack's holiday vision was unlike no other. So ring out the bells. There's more cheer to uncover.
Three lifelines extending help to those in need. Two passion potions that love and romance may succeed. On the first day of Christmas, my ghoul love gave to me a star.
Are you ready?
every year they do a special gingerbread creation, and this year it's a guillotine. You see it right down there. And when the guillotine comes down, it all goes red.
Close black bars until they lock into place. Thank you.
And like lock shock and barrel on top there. There's like the duelists up there that'll turn into ghosts and shoot at each other. Something that they have here but they don't have in Disney World is coming up, and that's the Hatbox Ghost. It's nice to see him again.
Oh, oh, oh. I'm really outdid myself.
I love Zero.
Look at all the happy faces.
Season greetings, everyone.
I don't remember the Sally being here last time. We've seen some videos with her, or of her, this time of year, but maybe that was there and I don't remember it. I love the singing pumpkin. And just when you think you're safe, there's Oogie Boogie.
Isn't this fun? I can't wait to see what you.
Then you get some kind of gift here. Ooh, I'm right in the middle, so. Oh, it's dynamite! How fun! Josh and Calvin. The weather is pretty nice today. It's 80 degrees right now. It's only supposed to get to like 85-ish. And it's overcast, so the sun's not beating down on us. So being 80 degrees and it being overcast makes for a very pleasant day. It is more humid here than it is in Colorado. And so we're feeling that, but it's not bad at all. It's actually fairly pleasant weather right now. And there's a bit of a breeze. Of course, we're near the water, so it could be because of that. But yeah, weather's pretty nice. We have a lightning lane for the Indiana Jones ride, but I think we're gonna try to get in a Pirates beforehand, since we have a little bit of time before that starts. So let's head that way. Oh yeah, here we are at Pirates. We weren't that far. And 15 minute wait, that's not bad. Perfect amount of time to wait for this. Over there's the Blue Bayou restaurant. Josh and I ate there once? Maybe twice, but definitely one time. And it's good. It's kind of expensive, and a lot of the food, and it shares a kitchen with Café Orleans, so we typically go there instead. But I do like that there's a restaurant there that is in the ride, essentially.
Bayou to get to the Pirates and the Caribbean.
I love this area here because it's cooler and there's the sound of running water, and I would love to have a like a bed here that I could just sleep in. The battle did not fare well for any of these people. Thank you. It's a lot of treasure. I think that's new. Oh, yeah, there's a octopus down there, too. Never seen that before. I just like that shadow up there. Pretty well done. Of this would work very well with him holding that guy up, but whatever. This scene isn't in the Disney World one.
Rascals and scoundrels, villains and knaves, they got me, Harley Joe.
The Tarzan treehouse is under construction. Nobody really knows what they're doing, if they're just kind of plussing it, or if they're refurbishing it, or if they're going to change it to something different. There's a lot of speculation, but I don't think anybody knows for certain. But you can't go up in it, not that we probably would have anyway, but you can't go up in it right now because it's completely covered in scaffolding and, well, some scrim, but not much. This video is getting much longer than I expected it to be, and so I'm going to split it off into two videos. So this is going to be the end of part one. Keep an eye out for part two and join us then.